Welcome back everyone. Now let's talk about object.create. This is the method available on object.create, right? And what it do, it takes object as an argument, right? It takes object an argument and you can overload it, create an object that has specified prototype or a null prototype. So either you can specify object or the object function prototype inside it. Okay, so here we are using object.create and passing person object to create a new object. So here the picture will be different than whatever we have seen in the previous video. So object.create person and person. So in this case, we are creating two objects, P1 and P2, and P1 proto and P2 proto, both proto is pointing to the person object and both will have a same value. So if you see P1.proto and P2.proto, both are same, right? So in this case, P1.proto and P2.proto both will return the true because both are equals. But in this case, P1 is not equal to person, okay? And P1 and P2 both are different objects. Like if you see, all are false, right? Because protos are same, because proto is pointing to the same person object. And person is not equal to, first of all, P1. P1 is not equal to P2. Their protos are equal and P2 is not equal to person. Alright. So what we did, object.create, object function has a create method, which is giving us a method create, which is used to create another object from the existing one. So it's just like inheritance, but it's not. So let's try to play around with this. Let's create a P1.name. P2.lastName, and now let's try to do console.log person. It's P2 not P, my bad. So let me try to print this again. Oh, this is ES6. I cannot declare the values again. Let's put it as var for now. Why it is still taking? I want to show only the output. We are not using const anywhere or let anywhere. That should be the fine now. Okay, so name is no name. So you can see I'm trying to print the person object, right? So I changed the P1 name and P2.last name, but person is still unchanged, right? It's not impacting. So it's a deep copy we are doing. Whatever you are changing on P1 and P2, it's not going to impact on the person object. Okay. So whenever you say the deep copy, this is another example for enumerable true properties. But if you're creating some property as enumerable false, that will not be a deep copied. That you should always remember. Okay, so let's try to visualize this, how it is happening. Is this will help us. So what we are doing, person is an object we created. Now we are doing object.create. Okay, so here object is a function and we have created the, and its prototype is pointing to object.prototype, and we created a person object, right? So person's prototype is pointing to the object prototype and person is pointing to this object. Clear till now? Here we have created a P1 and P2 object, and their proto, you can see their proto is pointing to person object first, and person's object proto is pointing to the object.prototype, and it's again proto is pointing to null. So if you do these things magically, if you try to print this console.log proto, where it is pointing? Can I print this value? Yeah, its proto is pointing to the constructor, so the person object, right? Similarly for P2, it's again pointing to the same person object, right? If I do __ proto here again, it is actually pointing to the object.prototype, empty object it should be, right? Empty object, it's coming. So p1 proto will pointing to the person object. Person object's proto will point to object.protype, and again it's coming as null. Again further proto will be null, right? So here we are not creating the object directly using constructor function of capital O object. We are inheriting, we are extending the person object. It's a deep copy. So its proto will point to the person object. Okay. That's it about this. Now we will talk about the last extension of this in the next video.